It's 11:15 at night, and I've been doing a lot of taping today. Continue to tape. We're not down at the Rockin' the Jukebox. It's some juke joint. We're just here saying, you know what? We could probably do a little better. Because if we don't, we're going to be stuck with this dream of non-eternal life. And as we all know, it's a terrible, terrible dream. Some have a little better understanding of this than others. The dream really is so terrible, it defies any description of terribleness. So don't even bother to try to describe it. There is a certain stillness and quietness at this time of night, taping outdoors. It's, most of the cars are gone off the road. Everyone's asleep. So we start out by being aware that we have this vast continuity problem. That's why we're here. Now the rest of the world, they don't think they have a vast continuity problem. So they say, why should we waste time with this? There's no value to that. They say, well, that's like someone who doesn't drink going to an AA meeting. You know, there's no value to that. So you don't go to an AA meeting if you don't drink at all and never have, right? That's what they think. So, but the fact is, everybody has a vast continuity problem, whether they know it or not, whether they're accepted or not. The sooner you accept it, the quicker you can get to the remedy. Now, we can start out strong by saying there is no deadline, and eternal life has no deadline. This tree doesn't have any deadline, has no deadline. There is no deadline for this tree. In eternal life, there is no deadline for this tree. This tree is deadline free. This plant as it is has no deadline. This plant is deadline free. this moves us closer to the vision of oneness, believe it or not. This table, as it is deadline free. This table, as it is has no deadline. This table is deadline free. The sound of a siren has no deadline. The sound of a siren is deadline free. This moment, as it is, has no deadline. This moment is deadline free. Now, what we're doing is we're maintaining the mood of repentance. So the quiet periods are just maintaining this. This world has no deadline. This world is deadline free. Now, we cannot directly explain so well how this works. In hindsight, we'll be able to see it. But we can certainly feel how it works. We can feel that this has an impact to it. There are no deadlines. Because there is no death in eternal life. There are no dead lines. As we're sitting here, the rain suddenly begins to fall. I don't have a deadline problem, I have a continuity problem. There isn't any deadline problem. The deadline problem has no value. Deadline problem has no value. There isn't any deadline problem. I don't have a deadline problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a deadline problem, what am I doing in this world? Here's the question. Why do we even need this world? I don't have a deadline problem. There is no deadline problem. So what are we doing pretending that there is? There's only one eternal life, just one eternal life. That's all there is. Don't try to grasp oneness mentally, directly mentally. Don't try to grasp it. It cannot be grasped, it can only be appreciated. The future of everything is deadline free. There's no place that anything has to be. Keep in mind that this plant being right here is also perfectly absent everywhere else, perfectly formless everywhere else. We too, having a body here, are, we could say, we're perfectly formless everywhere else. Everywhere else we're in the perfectly formless, unmanifest condition. And there's no deadline to be manifest or unmanifest. So really, you could say the unmanifest is the everywhereness. It's the ground of our being, is it not? Whatever you're looking at, keep in mind that it's only in this very small place, location, this manifest. And everywhere else, this is not manifest. So its nature is vastly unmanifest. The vastly unmanifest is the primal nature of all. So where's the bondage, really? Like the ocean with waves. The waves are like manifestation on the surface, but the ocean is like the unmanifest. And so everything's intrinsic nature is of the unmanifest. And only incredibly superficially do this trick of appearance appear like a ripple on the surface of the ocean. So when we say realize our true self, it means in essence realize the unmanifest nature of everything. The vast, unmanifest nature of everything. And just abide in that, rest in that. And everything that appears is just like the most superficial foam. Each raindrop that is falling is that raindrop is totally absent everywhere else. Everywhere else, right? So it's vastly unmanifest. And what concern does the vastly unmanifest have for any manifestation? How does that limiting anything? Because whatever manifests, it's absent everywhere else. A different way of looking at what we're perceiving, right? And we may say intellectually, well, so what? But we're not trying to get it intellectually. We're trying to get it at the level of appreciation, something deeper. You might say, wow, I'm incredibly unmanifest. Instead of trying to manifest more and more, saying, you know, no matter what I do here, I'm actually incredibly unmanifest. Investing in the incredible safety and comfort of that. And everything shares that kinship of the unmanifest, actually. And it's easy to see that the unmanifest is one. Equally unmanifest, it's all one. It's easy to see that. But we take it that the manifest is all there is. We feel thus everything's on the edge of an abyss if we think that the manifest is all there is. So what is the nature of the unmanifest? pure spaciousness. Pure everywhereness. So you see how the mood of repentance leads to astonishing results. I've literally never even thought about this before. You know, these videos actually amaze me greatly. I never realized that everything could just be, every appearance could just be the tip of the iceberg of the unmanifest. Of its unmanifest nature. That's just an astonishing type of insight. Came about because of the willingness to just sit here quietly without any preconceived thought or goal or anything, just be in the mood of repentance. I have a continuity problem. And then just somehow this idea occurred to me somehow. I don't know how. That's why they say that the intrinsic nature of everything is emptiness. Pure emptiness, pure emptiness. Everything resolves into the unmanifest. Everything resolves into the abyss-free nowness. The abyss-free nowness. Even an abyss is everywhere else there is no abyss. It's only where it is, but then everywhere else it's unmanifest as an abyss. So it's abyss free. The unmanifest is abyss free. So there is no abyss in the unmanifest. It's abyss-free nowness. purpose of being quiet is to allow these heavy, heavy insights to arise. After they arise, you remain quiet. So that you have time to get used to it. Very important. Mood of repentance is the pragmatic step that we have to take. Remaining expressionless, not trying to emote anything, not trying to be funny, not trying to be, you know, lively or effervescent or anything. We have a severe problem. So, you know, act like we have a very severe problem, vast severe problem, as the continuity problem. So we're very serious, very sober, very attentive. We're trying to accept the vision of oneness. We're trying to get to that acceptance. So just maintain this sobriety. Keep thoughts nullified. Don't follow any storylines. If something arises, say no value, no value. Just that's it. No value. So the bigger the insight, the more tendency we have to be very calm and not react at all. We make an extra effort. Otherwise, we'd flip over to the other side and get all carried away by it. Get all foamy. All bubbly and foamy. And so how vulnerable is the unmanifest? How vulnerable is the unmanifest? This is an interesting question. You might say that the manifest was only there to try and prove the vulnerability of the unmanifest. But how vulnerable is the unmanifest, really? And if this proves nothing at all, why even pay attention to it? Why not see it in a different way then? as proving nothing, and as all one, just one. Has no use as proof, has no value as proof. There are no techniques, really, as far as the mood of repentance goes, being practiced at all. There's nothing to keep track of as far as technique goes at all. Just serious, sober, serious. We're calm, non-reactive, non-emotive, non-projecting, non-blame, non-reactive, very non-reactive, non-emotive, non-reactive. Giving time for what we see to sink in and get used to it. So if all this form appearance proves absolutely nothing about the vulnerability of the unmanifest, then why is it even necessary for us to, what are we worried about it? This is a stunning, 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 stunning clarification. Which again was a complete surprise to me. And so when it comes, you just wait. You just sit here, you just wait. Like the ground, the rain comes down, and what does the ground do? It just lets the rain sink in. What else can it do? Just let it sink in. Gradually the ground gets, you know, absorbs the moisture like a sponge. Don't try to make anything of the insight, really. Just let it be as it is. You might say managing your insights. You know, you're the manager. So you learn to be a good manager. The better you are at that, the more insight will arise. Those who will not accept a mood of repentance, they're not going to get any good insights, for sure. Very superficial, just won't get it. If you want the really depth, crucial insights, you have to have this passivity. Almost like a neutral passivity, and just maintain that. Not judging what arises, just say, okay. Once it arises, you'll feel it reverberating in some way. Just let it reverberate. Like the bell has been struck, just let it reverberate. Don't try to do anything to stop it or increase it or anything. Just sit and wait. Don't try to amplify it or augment it, really. That gets in the way. Just let it reverberate. Try not to classify it or catalog it, categorize it, judge it, compare it. Don't compare it. None of those activities of the mind that we call judgment. Just say, well, it is what it is. Just let it be. No. Just stay neutral. Neutrally, passively neutral. Not thinking, what am I going to do with this? Do I need to add to it? Do I need to subtract to it? Extract from it? No. Just passively neutral. And we're coming up upon the realization, hey, I am the unmanifest. That is my true nature. Not just my true nature, it is the true nature. What we see as nature is not the true nature at all. That's an attempt to prove that our true nature is vulnerable. So, I mean, I'm getting, I sort of see in the distance, you know, the realization of true nature is not far off. You can sort of see in the distance from here. But instead of trying to, you know, grab a hold of it, just say, okay, it's there, it's over there. But meanwhile, I'll just get used to this. Just get used to it being over there. So I see it over there. Okay, don't try to pursue it. Just get used to it. It's over there. Okay, see, it's over there. Okay, fine. So, when you get close to realizing your true nature, just simply spend time accepting that you're close to realizing your true nature, that's all. And just be with that experience. This is an experience, and I'm close to realization, so this is an experience I'm having right now. So just let that experience take place. So this one is a challenge. You can feel the challenge of it. There's a lot of subtle agitation trying to arise, you know, and just let that all smooth out. Let it just naturally smooth out. So this is a challenging one. You come across this challenge. You can feel that your whole psyche is trying to react in some way. It's like the end of the road is near. The end of the path is near. That's in itself is a milestone. You have to smooth that out. You have to smooth it out. Otherwise, you'll get all uncoordinated as you go forward. The wheels will come off. You just have to normalize this fact. Just accept it, okay? This is where I'm at. Get used to it, get accustomed to it. Be patient. So this is a great, wonderful taping. Experiencing this here live is just great, because you get to see, just how you go about it. So I say, yeah, yes, the finish line is near. Okay, that's where I'm at, near the finish line. Okay, I'm just simply near the finish line. As usual, as normal, just be as is, as I am, as it is. This is as it is. And I don't have a finish line problem, I have a continuity problem. Don't have a finish line problem, I have a continuity problem. So bring it back to the continuity problem. I'm seeing this is grounding me. I don't have a finish line problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a self-realization problem, I have a continuity problem. So there's no question that there's this excitation, anticipation arising. So can't deny it. I'm probably going to suffer from it to some extent. But try to minimize it. Try to minimize it. Without suppression. You got to accept, be aware of where you're at without suppressing your awareness. Still, you have to let the awareness be there, but let it smooth out. Midnight, messy midnight. The water next door is going off. Or is it here? I don't know. Sort of, there's a thump, 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 thump inside of me, kind of. It's like something you've been searching for seemingly forever, and suddenly you catch sight of it. I just caught sight of my true nature. Just caught sight of it. You have to have the discipline to say, okay, it's gonna wander back into the forest, or I'm gonna move and the leaf will get in my way and I can't see it. But it's right there. It's right there. We're in the vicinity. In the vicinity of the self, for sure. In the vicinity of the self. Well, it's just, it's medicine I have to take, that's all. So, again, only problem I have is a continuity problem. The vision of oneness is the only remedy there is. It's simply a medicine I have to take, and I'll be taking it for quite some time, quite some time. So, the self, I've seen my medicine. Good, 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 good. That's fine. I'll be taking it for quite some time, so. Try, there's still reaction going on. Now, at this event, people try to go maybe eat a lot of food, you know, to try and get the reaction dampened that way. I have to try not to do that. So what do you do if you can't really dampen the reaction entirely? Do you get all upset or anything? No. Just say, okay, there's a little bit of reaction there. Fine. Just let that be then. In other words, don't compound the problem by reacting to the reaction. Reaction problem has no value. The reaction problem has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Reaction problem has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have a reaction problem. I have a continuity problem. See, at this point, I don't want to go any further. That was enough. That was enough. So, that helps too, is you tell yourself, okay, enough's enough, that's enough. I don't need to go any further. And I'm just going to give this the time to smooth out. Nothing to think about. Let this reactivity smooth out. We don't have to remember what we thought about to think about it. Don't try and think about it. Reactions already happened. The bell has already been rung. So it just letting it, the reverberations, you know, smooth out. It's already been rung. No point in trying to recreate it or say, how do I do that? How do I get back to that? Or I need to see what it was in order to calm it down. No. Keep your intellect out of it that way. Keep it out of it. Some try to, you know, pay attention to their breath, just count their breath and pay attention to their breath, or chanting, or something like that. Don't extrapolate to the future. In other words, stay in the moment. Stay in the moment. Something that, you know, stay in the moment without suppressing it. So this is a whopper of a one, no question. So there'll be some stress from this, yeah, for sure. That's the price you pay. That's the price you pay. And don't make it worse by trying to be perfect about it. That'll really fry you, you see. So basically accept that you have, there's some struggle here. And you say, okay, I'm not perfectly adept at all at this. There's some struggle. And let's let it be at that. Let it go at that. The trouble really comes when you try to say, my gosh, I've got to get this perfect. And then you get angry at yourself. You start forcing things. Don't do that. Don't do that. This isn't bad at all. It's not bad at all. It's minor. It's minor. But it's got some teeth to it. It's got some teeth to it. Eternal life is eternal life. Eternal life is eternal life. Eternal life is eternal life. Spaciousness is spaciousness. Spaciousness is spaciousness. Spaciousness is spaciousness. And you can go back to your practices. Just go back to your practices and just do that. Okay, I don't have a space problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a practice problem. I have a continuity problem. The spaciousness of this plant is the spaciousness of this plant. Okay, the spaciousness is the spaciousness. This moment is this moment. 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 So this is helping. This is helping. This is helping. This is self-released as it is. This moment is self-released as it is. This moment is self-released as it is. This plant as it is optimal. This table as it is optimal spaciousness. The spaciousness, this table spaciousness is optimal table spaciousness. This glass spaciousness is optimal glass spaciousness. This air spaciousness is optimal air spaciousness. This air spaciousness is optimally centered in the one vastness, the vastness of the one. This air spaciousness as it is optimally centered in the vastness of the one. The vastness of eternal life. This table as it is the heart of eternal life. This plant as it is the heart of eternal life. This stone spaciousness is the heart, as it is the heart of eternal life. This moment as it is the heart of eternal life. The heart of eternal life is the heart of eternal life. As it is, as it is, as it is. So, it's settling down, it's smoothing down now. My whole body's kind of a little tingly, buzzy, just there's this reverberation. But it is starting to subside and calm down now. This table as it is. This night as it is. This night is very great. You see, it's okay. I'm better. So that's intense practice. That's very intense. No question about it. When we talk about extreme right spiritual practice, this is just a great example of it. Very, very great example of it. And of course, every time that you're able to get through this, it gives you more confidence for next time. But you don't want to think about next time. You just stay in the now, let it settle down, keep your practice going. I have a vast continuity problem. It's the only problem I have, but it's a really vast, intense problem. Stay in the mood of repentance. Stay in the mood of repentance. All right. Very great taping to cap off an incredible day, actually. And we had the beautiful rain, and just the atmosphere is just unbelievable out here. Just unbelievably great atmosphere. Temperature is just like a paradise almost. It's just amazing. You can feel the slight dampness of the air from the rain now. The freshness. And it's mild. It's past midnight. It's really very, very awesome. So, okay, very great. Now it's time to just continue on with the routine of the day. Staying in character. Stay in the mood of repentance. And no problem. All right, that's it.